Good morning, students. In yesterday's video, we have seen till page number 108, keep the house clean and beautiful. And in that, we have seen a tidy house and a littered house. Now, today we are going to see a clean and tidy house is pleasing. If there is a mess everywhere, no one can find their things on time. Now, a clean and tidy house means jo ghar क्लीन और टाइडी होता है वो हमें अच्छा लगता है, राइट। इफ देयर इज अ मेस एवरीवेयर मीन्स यहाँ वहाँ कोई भी चीज़ें गिरी हुई हो, कोई भी सामान यहाँ वहाँ हो, तो वो हमें अच्छा लगता है क्या? नो, नो वन कैन फाइंड देयर थिंग्स ऑन टाइम, तो हमें हमारी चीज़ें भी टाइम पे मिलती नहीं है। कीपिंग द हाउस क्लीन एंड टाइडी इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ एवरी पर्सन इन द फैमिली। Now it is our responsibility that we should keep our house clean and tidy. ये हमारी जिम्मेदारी है कि हमारा घर हमें कैसे रखना चाहिए, neat and tidy. We should throw rubbish in the dustbin. जो भी rubbish सामान है वो हमें किस में throw करना चाहिए? In the dustbin and not throw it around. यहाँ वहाँ कहाँ पर भी फेंकना नहीं चाहिए, उस वजह से क्या दिखता है? घर बहुत गंदा दिखता है और टाइडी भी नहीं दिखता है, क्लीन भी नहीं दिखता है। तो इससे अच्छा क्या करें हम, जो भी है रबिश थिंग्स वो हम डस्टबिन में फेंक दें। गार्बेज शुड नेवर बी थ्रोन आउटसाइड द हाउस। जो भी कूड़ा कचरा है घर के अंदर वो घर से बाहर रोड पे नहीं फेंकना चाहिए, उसे भी हमें डस्टबिन में ही डालना चाहिए। दिस विल हेल्प टू कीप द एनवायरमेंट क्लीन। इस वजह से क्या होता है, हमें हमारा पूरा एनवायरमेंट, हमारा सराउंडिंग क्लीन दिखता है और अच्छा दिखता है। Now always remember, wet and dry garbage should be separated and put into the separate bins. Now wet and dry garbage, ये दो अलग अलग है, wet और dry garbage should be separated and put into separate bins. इनके लिए separate bins रखने चाहिए। Wet garbage is useful for making manure. Wet garbage, अभी आपके यहाँ पे भी, now at your home you can see that people who are coming to collect the garbage, they are making separate wet garbage separate and dry garbage separate. Paper, glass and metal can be sorted out from dry garbage and recycled. Now the things like paper, glass, metal, these things they are sorting it from the garbage, they are separating out from the garbage. जो भी कचरा हम डालते हैं उसमें से paper, glass, metal, इन सब चीज़ों को separate out किया जाता है और उसको recycle किया जाता है ताकि हम वो फिर से use कर सकें। Now do you know the use of electronic devices like mobiles, CDs, DVDs, pen drives and computers has increased greatly. Now day by day you also know you are also using mobiles, so nowadays electronic devices are used more. It is increasing greatly of usage of mobiles, CDs, DVDs, pen drives and computers. When these things are damaged, they become useless. Now whenever these things get damaged, for example if your mobile has got damaged, do we use it again? No, it has become now useless. You have to take new mobile. Or if example CD is damaged, DVD is damaged, your pen drive is damaged, you cannot make or you cannot repair it. Sorry, CDs, DVDs and pen drives, once it is damaged we cannot repair it, so they are useless. So this gives rise to e-waste. The disposal of e-waste is big problem. We cannot dispose these things. If these things get damaged, we cannot use it again. So disposal of these things becomes a big problem for us. Now try this, decorating the house. Get together and decide how you want to decorate the house. If you want to decorate the house, how will you decorate the house? You have to come together and decide it. Ask adults to help with those things that you cannot do yourself. There are some things which you cannot do. So you can take help of your elders and ask them to help you for decorating the house. What materials have you used for the decoration? What are the materials you have used for the decoration? Now in the list materials given below, put a cross against those materials that should not be used as far as possible. Explain why they should not be used. Now see, in the list materials are given below: flowers, thermocol, plastic, paper, rangoli, chemical colors. So you have to put a tick which materials you can use and cross which materials you cannot use. Flowers you can use for decoration? Yes. Thermocol can you use for decorations? Yes. Plastic? No. Paper? Yes. Rangoli? Yes. Chemical colors? If you want, you can, or else no. Now can you tell? Festivals. Now see in the picture, you can see there is a festival. Which festival is this? Just find it out, which festival is this? See, here it is written as Bail Poda. This festival is called as Bail Poda. Now why do we celebrate these festivals? What are our festivals linked to? We celebrate many festivals in the family. In the same way, different kinds of festivals are celebrated in different regions of the country. Now you know, in our India we celebrate many kinds of festivals like Diwali, Holi, Bail Poda, Gudi Padwa and Christmas. So these are many of the festivals which we celebrate, but different kinds of festivals are celebrated in different regions of the country. Okay, in different regions different kinds of festivals are celebrated. It is not that same festival is celebrated by everyone. No. Agriculture is the main occupation in our country. What is the main occupation of our country? Agriculture. Many of our festivals are related to agriculture and environment. Now, as you know that the festivals which are celebrating, they are all related to agriculture and environment. Wo sab kisse related hote? Agriculture se aur hamare environment se. Holi is the festival that marks the end of the winter. होली फेस्टिवल हम क्यों सेलिब्रेट करते हैं? क्योंकि वो क्या मार्क किया जाता है कि विंटर ख़त्म होने आया है, एंड ऑफ द विंटर. इन पंजाब बैसाखी इज सेलिब्रेटेड एट हार्वेस्ट टाइम. ओके, पंजाब में कौन सा सेलिब्रेट किया जाता है फेस्टिवल? बैसाखी. इट इज़ सेलिब्रेटेड एट हार्वेस्टिंग टाइम. इन महाराष्ट्र वी सेलिब्रेट बैल पोड़ा. इन महाराष्ट्र विच फेस्टिवल इज सेलिब्रेटेड? बैल पोड़ा इज सेलिब्रेटेड when the sowing of crops is over. During the harvest season in Tamil Nadu, Pongal is celebrated, while in Kerala they celebrate Onam. Dasara, Diwali and Gudi Padwa are celebrated with the farm produce is ready, when the farm is produced to ready. Now Dasara, Diwali and Gudi Padwa, these festivals are celebrated when the farm produce is ready, means jo bhi humne khet mein lagaya hai उसे प्रोड्यूस करते हैं, वो रेडी हो जाता है, तब हम ये फेस्टिवल्स सेलिब्रेट करते हैं. सो दीज आर द फेस्टिवल्स विच आर सेलिब्रेटेड बाय डिफरेंट रीजन्स इन अवर कंट्री. सो नेम्स ऑफ द फेस्टिवल्स आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट एंड द नेम्स ऑफ द प्लेसेस आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट. नाउ पर्युषणा पर्व, बुद्ध पूर्णिमा, रमजान ईद, क्रिसमस एंड पतेती आर इम्पोर्टेंट फेस्टिवल्स. These are all important festivals. Whatever the festival, all Indians take part in them happily and wish one another well. Whichever there is festival, all Indians come together, celebrate it, they wish each other and they are wishing each other very happily. Independence Day and Republic Day are our national festivals. Which is our national festivals? Independence Day and Republic Day. These festivals, we go in the schools and we celebrate these festivals, Independence Day and Republic Day. And we also get to know about the importance of Independence Day and Republic Day on these days in our schools. So this is our national festival. All citizens celebrate them. India gained independence from the British on 15th August. On 15th August, we got independence. From whom? From the British rulers. So, India gained independence on 15th of August from the Britishers in 1947. In which year? In 1947. Hence, that day is celebrated as Independence Day. The Indian Constitution came into effect from the 26th of January 1950. Why do we celebrate 26th January? Because the Indian Constitution which came into effect on which date? It came on 26th of January 1950. So this day is known as Republic Day. So these two are our national festivals, which is that 15th August and 26th of January. On 15th August, we got the independence, and on 26th January, the Indian Constitution came into effect. Now about it, you will get to know in front. Festivals bring people together. Why do we celebrate festivals? Because festivals bring people together. The feeling of togetherness grows. Festivals include songs, dances, rangolis, games, competitions and races. This gave us joy. While celebrating festivals, we must take care not to harm the environment. Why do we celebrate festivals? So that everyone get together and they can play songs, dances, they can make rangolis, games, competitions, races, and this, what does this happen, sorry, what does this makes? This makes a good feeling, a good vibe, and a happiness in the family. And this also gives us joy. So while celebrating this festival, we should also take care that we should not harm the environment. We should take care of our environment. Small children and old people suffer if music is played too loudly. Now small children, those who are very small, and the people who are very old age, they suffer from the loud music. So we should not play the loud music songs. Loud noises cause noise pollution. It also causes noise pollution. Loud noises also causes noise pollution. Now do you know, India has several Adivasi tribes. The Warli tribe lives in Thane district. So where do Warli tribe live? They live in Thane district. In June, at the beginning of the monsoon, they celebrate a family festival called Koli Bhaji. This is a festival called Koli Bhaji. They are celebrated by Warli people. Koli is a wild plant that is used as vegetable. Koli is a plant. It is used as vegetable. This plant grows after the rains begin. Family members go out into the surroundings and collect fresh tender koli. Family members go out and they collect the fresh tender koli. The vegetable is cooked and an offering is placed before the gods. Then all the members of the family eat together. See, again, do you know Makar Sankranti? Now the festival is coming, that is Makar Sankranti. Why do we celebrate Makar Sankranti? Makar Sankranti is a festival celebrated in winter. On this day, friends and relatives give each other tilgul. What do they give? They give tilgul, means sesame and jaggery. So it is called as tilgul. Sesame means til and jaggery means gul. So we call it as tilgul. Sesame is an important winter crop. So sesame, when it is grown in winter season. Sesame is good food for winter as it helps to keep us warm. It keeps us warm. So we should eat it in winter season. So we also celebrate this festival, that is Makar Sankranti. Now what we have learned from this chapter? In a family, we are secure in every way. Families are of different types. Small families, big families, extended families. A family tree shows several generations of people. Every household core is important. We must keep our house and surroundings clean. Many of our festivals are linked with the agriculture and environment. Independence Day and Republic Day are our national festivals. Festivals increase the feeling of togetherness among people. During festivals, we meet each other, talk to each other, and feel connected. So these are the points which we have learned from this chapter. You also revise it. Thank you.